Hello, welcome back to my channel, Qubit Education Services. In this video, we will be solving the third question, that is question number 33 from the ISR Aptitude Test Model Paper 1. This question is based on definite integration as well as the L'Hospital's rule. Assuming that the interchange of limit and integration is permissible, the value of limit as n tends to infinity of the integral from 0 to 1 n into x raised to n minus 1 divided by 1 plus x dx. Clearly x lies between 0 and is 0, 1 by 2, 1, infinity. Okay. Now we'll make use of the information given in the problem, which is we can assume that interchanging the way in which we solve this sum, that is, even if we first take the limit and then integrate, the answer is not going to change. That is the assumption, we can make use of that. Okay. So directly go to the integrand now. And in the integrand, don't consider the denominator momentarily. Just focus on the numerator because we are taking the limit as n tends to infinity and n is present only in the numerator. Okay. Now the first step is you should write x raised to n minus 1 in the denominator. Okay. So that will be x raised to negative n minus 1 or x raised to 1 minus n. Okay. And now comes the main part. Why can you apply the L'Hospital's rule here? Okay, because see, the numerator is, well, it is tending to infinity. Now it is interesting to see what happens to the denominator. Okay, because L'Hospital's rule will be applicable only when the denominator is also tending to infinity. Okay, we first go to the range of x. Okay, x is always going to be between 0 and 1. So choose any convenient value of x. Okay, let's take 1 by 2. Okay, and now if I raise 1 by 2 to any large power, okay, that will start coming closer and closer to 0, but it will remain positive. Okay, so if you take a very large power of 1 by 2 with a negative sign, okay, so large in magnitude but negative in sign, that is what's going to happen here. Then we need to take the reciprocal of that value which was very close to 0 but positive. So that will also start becoming bigger and bigger. Okay, so it will be in the infinity by infinity form, and therefore you can apply the L'Hospital's rule. Okay. But carefully note that we are not going to differentiate with respect to x. We are going to differentiate with respect to n. Alright, derivative of n is 1. And for this, you have to apply the a raised to x formula. Okay. So derivative of x raised to 1 minus n is x raised to 1 minus n into log x or log a in the formula into derivative of 1 minus n, which is negative 1. Okay, now having simplified this, we can again go back to the numerator. Alright. Yes, so you can write this x raised to 1 minus n, which is present in the denominator, again in the numerator. All right. Yes. And now log x, let it be in the denominator, and minus 1, you can write it anywhere. All right. Now what's important is x raised to n minus 1's limit as n tends to infinity. We again go back to our 1 by 2 raised to infinity example. That is going to tend to 0, right? Because 1 upon 2 lies between 0 and 1, and this is not only true for 1 by 2 but for any real number between 0 and 1. Okay, and therefore limit as n tends to infinity x raised to n minus 1 is 0 only because x lies between 0 and 1. Okay, so the limit is 0, and because the limit is 0, that means the whole integrand is 0 provided we first take the limit. So clearly the answer is 0. Okay, yes, so option A. Yeah, so thanks for watching. In the next video, we will be solving question number 34.